Hello, welcome to this video tutorial on WallaceiX. And so we continue the tutorial series today through looking at Wallacei analytics. This is going to be a short video tutorial. So in the previous video tutorial, we ran an evolutionary simulation comprised from 2,000 solutions, a population size of 2,000, where we had 100 generations and 20 solutions per generation. And we created our solution set. One thing that I'd like to note before I move on to Wallacei analytics is that if you happen to find yourself closing the window for whichever reason, first, what I would suggest is that always to, after conducting your evolutionary simulation, always to save your definition. This is primarily because if Rhino were to crash, this data right now is stored within the component. So if I were to close this user interface, you'll notice that the component's icon has turned purple. And this is just an indication that there is data from a previous simulation stored within the component. So if I were to double click on the component, yes, the live dynamic charts are gone, mainly because those are drawn dynamically, but you can still bring back the population objective space. But most importantly is that you can still continue to conduct any of the analysis you wish to conduct in these tabs. So if we move on to then to the Wallacei analytics tab, the first thing we need to do here is, and essentially what this tab does is that it helps us visualize all of the data outputted by the simulation for the different fitness objectives. In our case, we had three fitness objectives, and how we can cross-reference this data and extract specific solutions from the population. So first thing we have to do in this tab is click the draw button here. So once I click draw, you'll notice that these graphs and charts are drawn. And the charts are as follows. So the first set are the standard deviation charts. So unlike in the tab one, where it only showed the first generation and the last 50, in this tab, it shows the charts for all the population, for all the generations. You can double click on any of these charts and you can maximize them, and they can be quite nice when saving as screenshots. The second is the fitness objective, fitness value charts. And so what this chart shows is your solutions from generation zero to the latest generation. So each point here is a solution and each line is a generation. Going from red to blue. Thirdly is the standard deviation trend line. So essentially what this shows is that it shows the standard deviation factor per generation. So as we mentioned previously, a narrower curve indicates a larger standard deviation, which means more variation within the population, more or less. And a smaller or a narrower curve means a smaller standard deviation, meaning less values are deviated from the average, which means less variation within the population. So this is just another chart to visualize some of the data here in terms of just trying to see whether variation overall is increasing or decreasing within the population, or whether it's just fluctuating around a specific value. The final one is the mean value trend line, and this is essentially just the average fitness value per generation. So again, it simply shows the average fitness value for each generation and whether there is a specific trend to the average fitness value, whether it's decreasing or increasing throughout the population. So through a comparison between these charts, you can start to extract any emergent patterns or emergent behavior throughout the simulation, whether the simulation is actually working properly or functioning properly, or whether it is not. If you want to select a specific solution from the population, you can call its name, which is the solution number. So if I wanted solution number 5 in generation number 50, for example, and I click select, what this will do is that it will highlight the solution's location in all of these different charts. And it will also draw for me the what we call the diamond fitness chart. So essentially, the diamond fitness chart compares how well the different fitness objectives for this specific solution count. So in this specific case, it seems that it is very fit for fitness objective 2, less so for fitness objective one, and actually extremely unfit for fitness objective three. So the closer this dot on this axis is towards the center of this triangle, the fitter that fitness objective is. And through here, we can quickly also extract the actual true values. So this, so for example, we can tell here, fitness objective two, the solution is actually ranked 12th in the entire population. A second selection method is through actually the rank. So if I say I want fitness objective three, and I want the fittest solution, which is zero, and I click select, it's going to give me that solution. So the fittest solution for fitness objective three is actually generation 99, individual 12. So this was in the most recent generation. And we can tell here is that for fitness objective three, it is the fittest. So zero out of 1,999 or 2,000. And this is how it fares for the other two objectives. A very powerful feature from this analysis is that I will add a solution to my export list in tab three. So if I click add here, generation 99 individual 12 will be added to my export list. We'll come to the export list in the following video. For now, the Wallacei Analytics is, or the Wallacei Analytics section is a very powerful tool to extract specific solutions from the population and to try to see where those solutions and how they fare to in comparison to the remaining individuals in the population. In the next video, we'll look into tab three, which is the Wallacei selection tab. But for now, that's it for this video tutorial. Thank you for watching. We'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.